Today I'm going to teach you about kinetic energy. And we have this relationship, K equals 1/2 mv squared, K equals 1/2 mv squared. And this is a good one to just have memorized. It really helps to understand the deeper concepts when just the relationship is kind of in the back of your head. And you can make sure to memorize that using flashcards or whatever the best way that you can memorize kind of a string of variables. So what does this relationship mean? K equals 1/2 mv squared. It shows us that kinetic energy is directly proportional to the mass. And that's easy to see. Both of those are in the numerators. Kinetic energy is in the numerator here, and so is mass. It's in the numerator on either side of the equation. It's not under 1 or anything like that in a denominator. It's pretty easy to see, too, that if you were to increase mass, what would happen to kinetic energy? It's really easy to see. If you increase the mass on this side of the equation, then kinetic energy is going to increase. Now that's your standard directly proportional relationship. But there's this other piece to the relationship that we haven't seen yet. And it's the relationship between kinetic energy and velocity. Now, at first glance, it does make sense. Whoa, where did that come from? It does make sense that if you increase the velocity on this side of the equation, then the kinetic energy would also increase, and yes, that is correct. However, this square makes it so we can't just call this a standard directly proportional relationship. It is not a directly proportional relationship. It's something a little bit more special. And we would say it like this. Kinetic energy is directly related to the square of the velocity. I'd even mitigate this or amend this and say is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. Even I make mistakes sometimes. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. Now, what does it mean to be directly proportional to a square? Well, a square relationship is one where if x doubles, then y quadruples. So let's take a peek at this data set right here. We can see that x is definitely doubling. That makes sense. 2 times 2 equals 4. 4 times 2 is 8. And y is certainly quadrupling. 1 times 4 is 4, and 4 times 4 is 16. So looking at a data set, it's pretty easy to see a pattern here where as x doubles, y quadruples. So what would this look like in an example?